to bless him. Yes. And you still carry the mind of the ordinary. The reason why things are not going on right with you is because your mindset is still in the ordinary. Where are the superordinaries in this house? Where are the superordinaries in this house? Can I hear you make a joyful noise? Can I hear you make a joyful noise? Where are the superordinaries? The man who had done what no ordinary, Jesus Christ was super because everybody knew him. But Peter was doing what nobody has done. Yes. But all too soon, Peter started sinking because the ears of Thomas, the Thomases in your life, they say you are failed. They say you are too ugly to marry.
Yes.
They say you are too poor to be anybody. Nothing good can come from you. But tonight, even though the promises are speaking, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. God said that you tell you that you can do all things, that you can do all things, that you can do all things, that you can do all things. Look at the light. 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 Let me repeat that to you. Ordinary people don't walk on the sea.
That's true.
So many of you are dreaming to walk on the sea. Someone is a root of the sea. Somebody is asking me to get the leg, is it? Somebody's asking me, what is the water? What is the water that I want to walk on? Somebody's asking me, what is the water? Is it a book? Yeah, a book one.
Breathe on.
Yeah. And it is not about the bottleneck. It is not about the open. No, it is about the river in your life.
Hey.
The river of prosperity. The river of greatness. The river of power. The river of grace. The river of anointing. The river of power. Tonight, nothing will stop you, but we shall walk on. Nothing will stop you. We shall walk on. 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 Amen. Amen. It's necessary not to look at the factors of the family. Sometimes it is necessary to think out of the box. Even though I don't belong to the rich club, I'm in the box of poverty.
Yes.
I am thinking outside of the box of poverty to the rich.
Yes, amen.
Even though things are not perfect, you are even struggling to pay your rent, and you believe that very soon I'm going to buy a big house.
Amen.
If you can mention it, what you can fix it tonight, you will receive it. I said, what you can fix it tonight, you shall receive it. What you can fix it, you shall receive it. What you can fix it, you shall receive it. What you can fix it, you shall receive it. What you can fix it, you shall receive it. Somebody lift up your hand. Lift up your hand.
With God, all things are possible. asking today. Don't let someone look at you. Let me get it back, not about you. You will study. I said, as of today, let me tell you something small before I go. About 4 years ago, about 4 years ago, I used to be very poor. And I know you don't believe me by the show. I used to be very, very, very poor. I used to drive a car. But everything was not. And sometimes, before I started the ministry, this is very true. The paycheck that I was, it was a 12-hour job. And it was very, very hard. Very hard. You go there 12 hours, you're not sitting on your office, spend the whole 1 hour. And some of you are going through the same thing, telling you the same apology. And it's hard, but not hard. In the struggle, every paycheck I got, I was using the paycheck. This particular newspaper, I see them. It was one of them. I'm not turning that way. Every money that I got, I believe that one day, somewhere, somehow, God was going to make me a sinner. Amen. At that time, I had started a prayer line. And they were calling me pastor. But because there were so many that I named them, anytime I went to work, I was very funny to them. They thought I was there. What kind of pastor would come and work with me? But the work was very better, only better. Sometimes after work, you feel like you're coming from your family, like in America. But I believe that things were very hard. I would not let the hardship stop me. It was difficult. But little by little, every paycheck I got, my steps were very slow. My movement was very slow. But I wasn't looking at the storm. I wasn't looking at the hardship. I was looking at my God that is ahead of me.
Amen.
That if I can only touch the hem of the Lord's garment, if one day I can only reach out and touch the hem of the Lord's garment, I believe that my miracle, I will receive.
Amen.
In the struggle. In the struggle. One day I went to work. And I closed off work. The work was in a very dark, bush area. And then I was like, that's an old man. And I got out of the bus. The place, it was snowing very heavy. It was snowing very heavy. When I was trying to push the bus was in
the car. Ah,
from the place where the car had stopped to my workplace, if I have to drive, it's about 20 minutes or 15 minutes. But if I have to walk, and I started walking, I was trying to tell you. You know what was worse? In the middle of the car while I was walking, a black American man with a 4x4 stopped. He said, Kenny. Sometimes you can't be fast, you know. When he's like, hey, I said, oof, oof, oof. Then he said, what? I said, we're on a police operation. Move your car. We're on a police operation in the area. Move, because it was very dark. If I had sat in the car, I don't know, because he messed up and said, sitting. I said, you better move your car. The police is on operation here. Move your car. He was afraid, so he moved. When I got to my work, when I got to the place and they saw me with snow everywhere, the one lady that was just in front of me. Nights and nights and nights and cold coffee. Have you ever had nice cold coffee? Some of you, when you go to God, you say, I want to kill myself. Never ever kill yourself. In spite of the difficulty and the hardship, try and walk on. For the glory lies ahead of you.
Amen.
I said, for the glory lies ahead of you.
Amen.
Things might not be good. Things might not be perfect. Maybe every morning you are crying. Every night you cry before you sleep. Don't give up on yourself. I'm encouraging you tonight that try, and walk on. For the glory lies ahead of you. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
After so many months of working, I can lay me off. Let me finish it. Today, by the grace of God and by the grace of some members of this church, when I came to the gym, you know how the new friends are.
Yes.
If I'm driving too far, the guys can tell me coffee, and it's not that for me.
Sometimes if I press something, he says, all right, yeah, I'm good. My sister, can you walk on? I said, my brother, can you walk on?